We're really getting the rim sound today. I love it.
What's that?
We're getting a good rim sound. I love it.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to Ludholm Gymnasium on the campus of the University of New Hampshire.
for this Battle of the Border, brought to you by Buffalo Wild Wings, between the visiting Maine Black Bears and the UNH Wildcats. What's going on, everybody? Bailey Kennedy alongside me, Tim O'Sullivan. Tim, a great game we got coming up here. Battle of the Border, two teams, two rivals that don't really like each other. We should be in store for a good one. What should we expect?
Well, I think we should expect a hard-fought game, Bailey, not just because these two schools are rivals, but really because both teams need wins. Maine is coming off a three-game losing streak. It's the first time they've lost three conference games in a row in 10 years, so they're eager to get back on the right track. And for New Hampshire, the Wildcats have been playing some of their best basketball recently, but they're coming off a 22-point loss at Binghamton, so they need a win as they make a push for the conference playoffs.
Now, when we look at key players, you look at the main side. They lose a player of the year in Aiden Simon. They add in Adriana Smith, who only averaged 2 points last year. She's been unbelievable this year, too.
Yeah, the leaps and bounds that she has made this year has been incredible, as you see right there. She leads America East in both scoring and rebounding. She does a great job finishing inside, so it'll be up to New Hampshire bigs to kind of slow her down in the paint area this afternoon. And on the other side, we're going to take a look at Brooke Kane, senior forward from Derry, New Hampshire. You can see they're fifth in America East in scoring and rebounding, and Brooke has really been on fire recently. She's had 20 points or plus in three of her last four games, and on fire from three-point land as well. 9-for-14 from beyond the arc in the last three games for Brooke Kane.
Head coach for the Maine Black Bears, Amy Vachon. Once again, Maine comes into this one 12-12 on the year, 8-4 conference, but on a three-game losing streak. You talked about it in the open, Tim. They got to play with a little bit of a chip on their shoulder there. UNH and Maine both in the playoff picture, but this is a big one.
Yeah, no question. Big game for both teams. As we took a look at Kelsey Hogan right there and her counterpart, Amy Vachon, on the other side. Quite a record in her 6 years at Maine. 114-54 overall, and the Black Bears have been to seven straight America East tournament final games, Bailey. A pretty impressive run, but as you said, they're on a skid right now, so you know, we'll see how the Black Bears respond to this challenge in on the home court of their rival here in Lundholm Gymnasium, Durham, New Hampshire.
We're ready for the opening tip, and it's going to be Paige Cody winning it for the Wildcats, and they'll get the first possession of the game. Breezy Williams has it. She'll dish it off to Adara Groman. Back up to Brooke Kane. Ball movement right here, cross-court pass, looking to attack, going to the bucket, kicking out to Williams, up fake. Back out to Groman for three, off the board, but we're going to get a foul on the offense.
See Maine come out in a man-to-man defense. Good pressure on the Wildcats on that first possession.
That was O'Connor picking up the foul right there, her first, team first. So Maine will now get their first possession of the game right here, see what they can do. They're looking to find their star, Adriana Smith. It's up top with Sarah Hodgson. She feeds in to Smith, that shot off the glass and off the board, and rebound corralled by Williams right there. Good defensive possession right there. Feed in to Cody. She looks for the backdoor cut, Kane finishing.
And those two have had great chemistry this season, the two bigs for New Hampshire. Been able to find each other, get the first points on the board this afternoon.
Maine working around, trying to get something. It's with Olivia Rockwood. She feeds into Smith. Cody giving her some room. Cross court pass, the three, butter right there from Sarah Hodgson.
The New Hampshire native didn't score any points in Maine's last game at NJIT, so I'm sure Sarah loved seeing that one go down from downtown.
Yeah, Hodgson, the sophomore, as there's the three, and answering back with a three of her own is Groman right there.
Adara's second three of the game. Second three-point attempt, I should say. Now 1-for-2.
Smith has it in the post. Her shot rejected right there, and board going to be corralled by Groman.
They are paying a lot of attention, obviously, to Adriana Smith. They were face guarding her the first couple possessions. Threw a double team her way right there.
Just good, solid defense so far. Williams has it. Williams looks to attack. She takes the jump shot, takes a little bit of contact. Can't get the friendly roll to go right there.
And she was definitely looking for the foul. Thought she got hit on the way up by Paula Gallego. You see Gallego on the other end.
Offensive foul.
Nice job by Adara Grohman right there, Bailey. Adara does such a good job anticipating offensive moves and being able to take those charges. We're going to take another look at it here. Sets the feet, gives up the body, gets the turnover.
Yeah, good defense. You know, defense creating offense right there. I mean, you draw a foul, but that's good defensive possession right there. And so Williams has it up top, and UNH will look to attack once again. Up top with Cody. Getting it to Williams. Williams thought about taking the three. Back to Cody. She takes the free throw line extended jumper. No good. And it's with Bornman. Bornman looking to attack. Kane preventing her from going to the middle. Back up top. Looking to go right here. Abby Lawrence